Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Your Excellency President Ghani, Your Excellency First Lady, Ambassadors, distinguished guests, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen. Good morning and welcome to the 21st Joint Coordination and Monitoring Board meeting. A special welcome to my colleagues, Tademichi Yamamoto, and thank you to the UN for co-hosting this important meeting with us today. Thank you for all of you for being here today to participate in this important meeting and then leading up to the 2018 Geneva Conference on Afghanistan. Today we're meeting here as partners on Afghanistan's development journey halfway through the decade of transformation to take stock of our achievements and to work on the work that remains. There's a thread of connectivity throughout the reform agenda as articulated in Afghanistan's National Peace and Development Framework and National Priority Programs. What's more important than a sectoral achievement is indeed our collective impact of the programs made in the reforms across the government. Indeed, what we're doing is nothing short of changing the way we govern and in turn changing what Afghans expect of their government. This morning, I'd like to touch briefly on a few areas of reform, which are then we'll explore more in depth throughout the course of the day. At the foundation of all of our reform is the improvement to public finance management, budgetary and fiscal reforms. The goal is to achieve self-reliance, as no country has gone from poverty to prosperity from aid alone. As donor funds gradually reduce, we're now instituting systems that to make sure we increase revenue collection and utilize existing public funds in a more strategic way. Macroeconomic stability and fiscal reforms have been one of the most fundamental and substantial achievements over the past few years. As a result of getting our financial affairs in order and implementing anti-corruption and taxation reforms, our domestic revenues has increased from 99 billion AFs in 2014 to 169 billion AFs in 2017. Our targeted revenue collection for 2018 is 172 billion AFs, an increase of over 70% compared to 2014. Reforming the budget was one of the major achievements of 2018. The 2018 budget is more realistic, taking into consideration the absorption capacity of the budgetary entities, setting a credible baseline and fully disclose an unprecedented level of increased transparency. We base the budget on international budget practices, such as using consolidated single currency and applying the rules of use it or lose it instead of automatic carry forward. More importantly, we highlighted the key risks to fiscal sustainability, such as cutting many projects in budget that had no available funding or little relevance to the government's policies. Structural reform across government related to sound financial management have also been a key issue, including improvement in the banking sector, reform of the customs and revenue departments, enactment of the new panel of penal code that criminalizes bribery and corruption, and amendment to the anti-corruption law to achieve what the heads of the law enforcement and custom agencies declared assets. The focus is now in sustaining and further institutionalizing these reforms. We have far to go in achieving a policy-based budget aligned to the ANPDF. We will work very closely with government agencies, the cabinet, the parliament, and our partners to do this. I'd like to take this opportunity to acknowledge my predecessor, Minister Akhil Hakimi, and the tremendous job he did in leading the Ministry of Finance and implementing these reforms. It was no small feat, and his leadership was essential in realizing these achievements. Moving forward, we'll be focusing on leveraging public funds for private sector investment and investing in development programs to address the needs of the Afghan people. Government funds should not only be used for expenditure, but also to manage bringing sizable investment, growing the economy, and creating jobs. We have laid out our national development priorities, the 10 national priority program, 8 of which are now completed and are being operationalized. I'll touch briefly on a few of these achievements. In the ANPDF, we promised to complete the 500 kV national grid and become energy self-sufficient within a 15-year period. In the last 15 months alone, we have connected 9 of our provinces to the power grid, while in the past decades or so, there are many years that even a single province had not been connected. Moreover, in all of these provinces, we're able to reduce the cost of electricity by a factor of 5 to 6. And ironically, these were some of our poorest provinces. Energy as a matter of all infrastructure and growth for every society. So you can imagine the effect that these will have in these specific areas and the kind of potentially exponential growth that they're going to see in the future. They're also prioritizing regional connectivity for growth and security. Placed in the heart of Asia, Afghanistan naturally has the potential to be the connector between South Asia and Central Asia, be a hub of trade and transportation of energy and data. With key regional energy projects such as TAPI pipeline, CASA 1000, TAP, which are full underway, we are making progress in realizing this vision for regional connectivity than we had seen in the past decade. They've also opened up multiple new air corridors, further linking Afghanistan to its critical bilateral trade partners such as Uzbekistan, India, Kazakhstan, Turkey, and Saudi Arabia. Afghanistan's export volume reached a total of 784 million, an increase of 27.7% in 2017. The foundation of an informed and productive citizenry is, of course, education. 2018 has been declared as the year of education reform by President Ghani. Building on the reforms we have initiated for higher education and vocational training programs. Earlier this year, the government launched its new package of human capital and education initiatives. The Technical and Vocational Education and Training Board will establish at least one TVET school in every province by 2020, and by 2021, one in every one of our 340 districts. The TVET programs will adopt the traditional Afghan apprenticeship model, which is very close to the German training model, and it's designed to instill technical and practical skill sets in Afghanistan for Afghanistan youth to adequately match their skill sets with the demands of the Afghan job market. Afghanistan is also on its way as one of the handful of countries that has made an agreement with MIT edX online programs where we'll be, our students and faculty will have access to the courses of the top 200 universities across the world, which will really significantly improve the quality of education, higher education in Afghanistan. Afghanistan is one of the most mineral-rich nations in the world, yet being one of the poorest. Mining sector reform are underway to exploit natural resources carefully and cleanly to benefit the entire public. These are but a few highlights, and moving forward, we expect that operationalizing and financing of all of the NPDF priorities will require not only the financial resources committed at Brussels, but new development partnership made that promotes sustainable support to the national agenda and channel funds through national systems and national budget. We ask the international community for your continued collaboration in this regard. As we celebrate these achievements and progress on our journey into self-reliance, we face great challenges. a tremendous amount of hard work remains ahead of us, and we continue to experience violence at the hands of the terrorists across many areas of the country. Agriculture, which drives our economy, remains vulnerable to spontaneous natural disasters. Today, we are experiencing a terrible drought that has impacted millions of people across two-thirds of our country. Such crises require our consolidated focus and resources, and we continue to balance implementation of our framework agenda and competing priorities. I look forward to hearing from my colleagues throughout today in delivering into these sectors. I once again thank you for all of you for being here and your continued support and commitment to Afghanistan. Thank you.